Assalamu alaikum, dear learners. How are you? Hope that all of you fine, safe and sound. I am also fine, by the grace of Allah Ta'ala. Dear learners, the present world is experiencing the devastation of the coronavirus, and we are going through a very crucial moment for the COVID-19. So if we want to get rid of this coronavirus, we have to know some rules of hygiene so that we can prevent ourselves from this COVID-19 situation. So dear learners, yes, our today's lesson is hygiene. This is in unit 3, lesson 2. Dear learners, before going to the text, as usual, today we also try to know the meaning of some vocabulary. Yes, there are some keywords. Here we have hygiene, godliness, achieve, spiritually, so. So dear learners, let's try to know the meaning of all those key words. First one is hygiene. It means sanitation or cleanliness. You can write sanitation, or you can write cleanliness. Next one, godliness. It means the quality of being devoutly religious. That means religiousness. Next, achieve. It means attain something, acquire something, achieve. Next, spiritual. It means moral. And the last one is soul. It means the spiritual part of a human being or an animal. So dear learners, have a look. Hygiene means sanitation or cleanliness. Godliness, the quality of being devoutly religious, or we can say religiousness. Next, achieve, it means attain something, or acquire, we can say acquire. Next, spiritually, it means morally. And the last one is soul, the spiritual part of a human being and animal. Now we will read the text. There is activity A. Read the questions first, then read the text and answer them in short. Learners, here are three questions for you. The first one is, what can be a hotbed of germs? Second one is, how many times should we brush our teeth a day? Number three, what kind of water should we drink? So dear learners, we have to search the answers of those questions from the text. If we go through the text and if we understand the meaning of the text, then we will be able to answer the questions of the three questions. Okay learners, now go through the text. The word hygiene means the practice of keeping ourselves clean. It also means to keep our home and workplaces clean. It is important for our good health. Hygiene is thought to be next to godliness. It is because we cannot achieve anything physically, mentally or spiritually if we are unclean in our body, mind and soul. Nobody likes an unclean person either. So he must follow the rules of hygiene. So dear learners, let's discuss the first two pairs of the text. So here we have got a word which is emphasized here, and the word is hygiene. Hygiene. What does it mean? From the keywords, actually, we have come to know the meaning of this hygiene. That means sanitation or cleanliness. So if I give the definition of the hygiene, I can say the practice of keeping to maintain health and prevent disease. The practice of keeping ourselves healthy and preventing disease through cleanliness is called hygiene. So I can write, the practice of maintaining health and preventing disease, especially so cleanliness. So dear learners, what I have written, the meaning of hygiene or the definition of hygiene, the practice of maintaining health and preventing disease, especially through cleanliness. So here in the text, we have got a sentence that is, hygiene is thought to be next to godliness. So we can say that here hygiene is compared to godliness. And what is the meaning of godliness? We have got the meaning of the godliness is the quality of being devoutly religious. That means religiousness. So here I can say that hygiene is very close to the religion. And here also tells that it is because if we cannot achieve anything physically, mentally and spiritually if we are not clean in our body, mind and soul. So we have to clean our body, we have to be clean in our mind and soul also if we want to achieve something, because health is very next to godliness. Okay, so what is this means refers actually? It refers that, people have a moral duty to keep themselves and their homes and surroundings clean. People have a moral duty to keep themselves and their homes and surroundings clean. Actually, if we try to maintain hygiene, all of us have to a moral duty to keep ourselves clean, to keep our home clean, to keep our surroundings, our environment clean. And here, we can get that nobody likes an unclean person either. We don't like any unclean person. So if I or you don't like any unclean person, so what should we do? We have to be clean ourselves. We have to keep ourselves clean. Then people will like us. People don't avoid us. Okay, learners, let's go through the next pairs. First, we must keep our body clean. We should have a bath every day and wash our hair regularly. This will keep the body and hair free from dirt and bacteria. So here we actually get the rules of maintaining hygiene. Secondly, we should wash our clothes regularly. Dirty clothes give off bad smells and invite germs. Okay, first one, the rules that we have to take bath regularly. And the second, we get that. We have to wash our clothes regularly because dirty clothes can be the hotbed of germs. It can spread germs. So we have to wash our dirty clothes. We should wear socks and shoes when we go out to protect our feet, from dust and germs. It is important to wash our hands before meals and after using the toilet. We should brush our teeth twice a day, after breakfast and supper. We must also cut our nails regularly. Our drinking water must be safe. We can get safe water by boiling and filtering. Finally, we should keep our surroundings and environment clean. If we do and follow all the above things properly, we will be able to lead a healthier and happier life. So, dear learners, in all those paras, actually, we have got the rules of hygiene, the points of maintaining hygiene. At first, we have got that we have take a bath every day. We should take a bath every day. But two, we can say that we have to wash our clothes. Wash our clothes. Brush our teeth. After breakfast and supper, we have to ensure brushing our teeth twice a day, after breakfast and after supper. Next, wash our hands. We have to wash our hands, we have to clean our hands with soap, or we can sanitize our hands by using any alcohol based hand rub. So we have to wash our hands before meals and after using the toilet, which is very important. We have to wash our hands before meals and after using the toilet, or we can say that after touching anything we have to wash our hands. Next, things right, drink safe water, because water is life, but pure water may be the cause of our death also. So we have to drink safe water. We have to ensure that we are drinking pure water. And how can we get a pure water? Yes, we can get pure water by boiling water or by filtering it. Dear learners, with all those rules, we can add some other rules considering the present COVID situation and writing all those. Avoid touching eyes, nose, and mouth. And we have to avoid touching eyes, nose and mouth with our hands, because our hands carry various kinds of germs. So we don't touch our eyes, nose and mouth. Next we can write, keep safe distance. At the present situation, we are asked to keep safe distance so that we can get rid of germs. Eight, I can write, avoid shaking hands and hugging. The present COVID situations compels us to avoid shaking hands and hugging because it spreads the virus. It helps to spread the virus. At last, I can write, follow good respiratory system. Follow good respiratory system. That means we have to cover our mouth. We have to cover our nose with the bent elbows or with the tissues when we cough and sneeze. And we have to dispose the used tissues immediately in the proper way. So, dear learners, if we follow all those rules of hygiene, I think we can be able to protect ourselves and we can be able to get good health or sound health. And finally, we should keep our surroundings and environment clean also. We don't throw our wastage here and there. We should have to dump those wastage properly. If we do and follow all the above things properly, we will be able to lead a healthy and healthy and happy life. So this is the those are the last lines of the lesson. If we do and follow all the above things properly, we will be able to lead a healthy and happy life. So dear learners, I think now you will be able to answer the three questions that are beforehand of the text. What can be a hotbed of germs? Yes, learners, I think you have guessed. Dirty clothes can be a hotbed of germs. Number two, how many times should we brush our teeth a day? We should brush our teeth twice, after breakfast and supper. What kind of water should we drink? Yes, learners, I think you know the answer. This, that we should drink pure or safe water. We can get pure water by boiling or by filtering. Learners, in the lesson, there are other three activities. Activity B, Activity C, and Activity D. I think if you understand the lesson, you will be able to answer and you will be do the activity properly and you will try it at home. And so you have to go through the lesson again. Dear learners, all those for the day, keep yourself safe and sound. Allah Hafiz. Assalamu alaikum.